the ivory-billed woodpecker is said to be extinct, but sightings of the bird still continue to this day. Today we're going to take a look back at the ivory-billed woodpecker story, and hopefully one of you watching this video will be the one to find evidence that this bird exists. The ivory-billed woodpecker is the largest woodpecker in the United States and has a very distinct look. With a wingspan that stretches 2.5 feet long, it is slightly bigger than the common pileated woodpecker. The ivory bill has a prominent head crest that is red on males and black on females. There are white feathers on the inner and outer parts of its wings, which is unique to the ivory bill. Most descriptions of the bird in flight note that the wings almost look entirely white as they flew by. When perched, both males and females have a large patch of white on the lower back, rather triangular in shape. These characteristics distinguish them from the larger and darker billed pileated woodpecker. The pileated woodpecker normally is brownish black, smoky or slaty black in color. It also has a white neck stripe, but the back is normally all black. Pileated woodpecker juveniles and adults have a red crest and a white chin. The ivory bill also makes a double knock on trees that is said to have been very quick and deep. Descriptions of this bird also note how fast of a flyer it was and that it was very noisy. The official range of the bird is not known officially, but the accepted range is that it's ranged from eastern Texas to North Carolina and maybe as far north as Illinois. Although there are reports and remains of the bird that have been found in Ohio, Kentucky, West Virginia, and Pennsylvania as well as other states, recent sightings seem to be focused in Arkansas and Florida though, which was always the bird's strong points. The bird was declared extinct in 1944, but numerous sightings led the bird to be taken off the extinct list in 2004. Here are some notable sightings past 1944. In 1967, ornithologist John Dennis, sponsored by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, reported sightings of ivory-billed woodpeckers along the Neches River in Texas. HNAG and GM Hainsman reported observing one or two ivory-billed woodpeckers in Highlands County, Florida on 11 occasions from 1967 to 1969. LSU University Museum Director George Lowry presented two photos at the 1971 annual meeting of the American Ornithologists Union, which show what appeared to be a male ivory-billed woodpecker. In 1999, an LSU forestry student reported an extended viewing of a pair of birds at close range in the Pearl River region of southeastern Louisiana. Gene Sparling reported seeing an ivory-billed woodpecker in Cache River National Wildlife Refuge in 2004, prompting Tim Gallagher and Bobby Harrison to investigate, who also observed a bird they identified as an ivory-billed woodpecker. An expedition led by John W. Fitzpatrick of the Cornell Lab of Ornithology followed, which reported 7 convincing sightings of an ivory bill. The team also heard and recorded possible double knocks and cant calls and produced a video with 4 seconds of footage of a large woodpecker, which they identified as an ivory bill due to its size, field marks, and flight pattern. Scientists from Auburn University and the University of Windsor published a paper describing a search for ivory bills along the Choctaw River from 2005 to 2006, during which they recorded 14 sightings of ivory-billed woodpeckers, 41 occasions on which double knocks or cant calls were heard, 244 occasions on which double knocks or cant calls were recorded, and analysis of those recordings and of tree cavities and bark stripping by woodpeckers they found consistent with the behavior of ivory-billed woodpeckers.